So we had to be an empathetic listener and really begin that process of helping support those businesses to know that there are people out there that can help them. So we heard reopening and reassurance, financial support, advocacy, business pivoting, industry connections, and we were able to deliver the program in multiple languages, as you see here. To date, over 826 businesses are in that program and have a formal program advisor. You can see we've had over 10,000 points of contact with those businesses. So it's a very intuitive, long-term, back and forth the dialogue to help those businesses as best we can. Coupled with that, we're also measuring and understanding visitor patterns daily, weekly, but also understanding what people are saying about us online and how we're managing this process and how the destination is being managed. We've heard lots from presentations today about data, and we've been very focused on building new partnerships to understand those patterns. And we were looking at the week over week and we bottomed out for a domestic visitation, bottomed out in about April, about 82%. And we were able to start to rebuild back domestically and quite frankly, in the province of BC, one of the strongest regions in the province to weather as much as we can the impact of the pandemic from a domestic visitation perspective. We then shifted in the month of the summer into recovery and looking at, again, what I mentioned, partnerships, helping these businesses understand and get those support. So access to experts, reducing operating costs, access to capital, access to mental health support, and understanding resident sentiment, from what we heard today, were aspects of this evolution. Establishing this framework where, and again, I appreciate what Sergio was talking about, webinars. We've been delivering educational tools daily, weekly on different webinars and with high attendance engagement in those efforts. And this is done, again, within a framework partnership provincially. We were able to access and develop a partnership on health and safety training for business. And so that they can open safely and for their employees and of course their customers. And we provide one-on-one consultations to achieve that. We were able to provide one-on-one virtual coaching sessions with experts from our local university. And that has been established. We've been able to establish a partnership with our hydroelectric company and various other partners to provide a dedicated resource to help different businesses reduce their energy consumption, which ultimately reduces their monthly bills and of course, greenhouse gas impact. We were able to work with our local banking institutions to establish a local tourism microloan program. We're seeing a lot of our chartered banks, seeing tourism as a high risk. And we needed to work with the banking institutions to establish a specific program to address that need. We were able to work with the Canadian Mental Health Association to establish personalized one-on-one support services for both employers and their employees who are facing serious mental health challenges. We were able to access innovation initiatives, and we established an innovation lab, which is providing peer-to-peer counseling sessions to help businesses pivot under 9 unique topic areas recommended and requested by businesses. And a number of business participants have already gone through this program. We've worked obviously with the World Travel and Tourism Council to utilize their safe travels designation to, again, encourage businesses to adopt the global standards of protocols, but also to give the visitors and residents a much more safer feeling. We were also able to engage our universities across this region to provide a series of youth this year, interns who have been really scouring and working with all the initiatives I've just talked about to really advance those initiatives. Because of course, as a small organization, we needed to bring in that support. And resident sentiment, which we've heard today, we've been established a relationship with our university and Planet Happiness to begin that process of measuring this effort and through this index. But we have worked with all our community partners who have been surveying the residents and understanding that and seeing what that feeds into. And as Sarah pointed out, we've been reviewing the Destination Canada data as well on an ongoing basis. So when looking forward under the resiliency effort, we want to build back sustainably. We're going to look at a very strong focus around climate-friendly travel, but being much more transparent with the data that's out there and this commitment to generational thinking. And so we have signed on with the future of tourism and being and reinforcing those guiding governance principles of sustainability. We've established a partnership with an organization called Climate Friendly Travel and SunX. And there's a whole bunch of initiatives around that. But right now we're in the midst of launching a new data platform. Probably not as sexy as what we saw in Argentina, but it will be comprehensive in its approach to looking at how we be, again, even more transparent than ever before in the sharing of data. And finally, in terms of how we as an organization govern ourselves, we base ourselves on values, and those core values drive how we govern as an organization. And our pledge that we have for visitors, for industry, and of course, organizations like ourselves has been well engaged in terms of resident sentiment and helping establish and reestablish the destination as a safe place and a caring place. So in order to what we've seen in this is we've recognized the fragility of the tourism industry. We've understood the interconnectedness of the tourism industry like ever before. And the need to work together to learn from best practices. And that's why we really are proud to be a part of the INSTO network, because we need to live in harmony with our communities. The communities are the most important part of this journey that we've seen. And the pandemic has really brought so much light to that. And so obviously we want to build back more resilient and stronger. So thank you very much for this opportunity to quickly share with you what's going on in our part of the world.